Hey everyone, Raj Dew for Reckoner, and today we are taking a look at these guys, the YubiKey 5 series from Yubico, and in particular the YubiKey 5C NFC and the YubiKey 5CI. Now, if you have no idea what these are, don't be afraid, you are definitely not alone. I'll do my best to explain what they are and why you should consider using them to tighten up your online security and safety. So what are they? Well, to explain that, we'll need to talk about two-factor authentication, or 2FA as it's more widely known, and those annoying websites that send us codes to type in after we enter our passwords. Now, you normally get those codes via a text, email, but some of you likely have apps like Google Authenticator or Authy set up that generate the codes for you. And those codes are only valid for a short amount of time, and that extra layer of security is great, but even those can be easily accessed by hackers, especially if you receive them via email or SMS. In fact, SMS is probably the worst way and has led to more of the major security breaches in the past decade than anything else. So enter Yubico and the YubiKeys. And using the simplest of simple explanation, these guys act as a special key. When you turn that key by plugging it into your computer or tapping against your phone, it unlocks access to your list of one-time codes that are stored on it. And those codes are displayed via the Yubico Authenticator app, which if you've used Google's version, looks and works pretty much exactly the same. Really, all the YubiKeys are doing is shifting the access and storage of these automatically generated codes to a physical form instead of virtually in software. Now, to be fair, that's not the only way of using a YubiKey. In addition to handling one-time passwords, they also support a variety of new authentication protocols like FIDO and U2F. Those likely mean nothing to you like they did to me, but to break it down, if you're using websites that support them, like Twitter or Google and Facebook, just plugging in your YubiKey and tapping it can authenticate you without having to open up another app or type in extra codes. Now, these protocols aren't widely spread as yet, but Yubico has a really cool portal that lists those that do, as well as linking you to instructions for each of them on how to set it up with your YubiKey. Now, there are a variety of YubiKeys available depending on what phone and or computer you want to use them with, and range in price from around 50 to 90 Australian. The 5C NFC, for example, is around 80 bucks and has a USB-C connector, but it can also be used with newer Android and Apple phones with the NFC sensors. The 5CI, on the other hand, has both a USB-C and a Lightning connector, whereas the Nano range is designed to discreetly plug into your computer via USB A or C. Yubico have a really good tool on their website that will help you pick the best key for you depending on what devices you plan on using it with and how you'd like it to work. For me, using a MacBook Pro and an iPhone, the 5C NFC is my favorite, but I could just as easily use the 5CI. Now, all of that sounds great, but I think most of you will be wanting to ask the same question as me when I first looked into them, which is, what happens when you lose your key? Well, basically, it's the same thing as when you lose your phone or somehow accidentally delete the Google Authenticator app. Ideally, you have some 2FA backup code somewhere safe, and you have them, right? Well, if you're nodding your head, you'll be using one of them to get into your account and disable and re-enable 2FA on a new key, and voila, you're done. But if you're shaking your head or you're unsure about what 2FA backup codes even are, well, that's a different story. And depending on the website you're now locked out of, you'll need to go through some sort of recovery process. And this is no different to if someone hacked your email or spoofed your phone number and you stop getting your 2FA codes in the first place. It can be a painful process, so be sure to save them backup codes. But there is a better option though, and that's simply to buy a second YubiKey. Having a backup means that when you add a new website to your Yubico Authenticator, you'll need to do it again for your backup key, but that's a hell of a lot more convenient than going through a recovery process, let me tell you. Now, for the security savvy of you out there, you're probably screaming that 2FA apps like 1Password and Authy allow you to sync your 2FA codes across multiple computers and devices, meaning that you have a cloud backup, and that is 100% correct. You essentially have as many backups as you do devices that access it, but for each of those devices, you're also X number of times more vulnerable to being compromised, and a physical entry point significantly narrows your security exposure. In today's world, there is absolutely no reason not to use 2FA. Username and passwords are compromised so often these days, we've basically become desensitized to it. A good GPU will crack a password hash in seconds, so having another layer of security is an absolute must. For many, that might be taking their first step into not adding a 1 to the end of the same password they use everywhere. For others, that's making use of a password manager like LastPass or 1Password. But for those that want to go one step further, and I highly encourage you to do so, a YubiKey for $50 is by far the best way to do it.